Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. الحمد لله وكفى والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, maybe some of us are weak due to the situation, due to the life that we are living, or what is surrounding us, or what is happening to you, or what is happening to her, or what is happening to me, what is happening to us is making us weak. But believe me, brothers, we have someone who can make us strong. Allah. He is Al-Qawi, the strong. He is Al-Qawi, the one whose strength is supreme. Allah. Allahu latifun bi'ibadihi yarzuqu man yasha' wa huwa al-qawi al-aziz. Allah. He is the strong, and his strength is mighty, is supreme. His strength is supreme. So whoever is weak due to the situation, due to your living, whatever is happening to you, believe me, go back to Al-Qawi. He will make you strong. May Allah make us strong in everything that we are doing. May Allah protect us. My dear brothers, I bear witness, he is one and only, and I bear witness our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers, Abdullah ibn Salam, a rabbi, he was once a rabbi, a Jewish rabbi. Before he accepted Islam, he said he was living in Medina. So one day when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to Medina, people were rushing and running and gathering to see him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a man of knowledge, Abdullah ibn Salam. He was a Jewish rabbi. So he said, when I heard that, I went. Also, I followed the people just to look at him, just to see him. He said, "Araftu anna wajhahu laysa biwajhi kadhab." He said, when I gazed, I looked at the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I knew that this face is not a face of a liar, Muhammad. At that time, he wasn't a Muslim. He was not a believer. But looking at the eye of the Prophet, he said, "Araftu anna wajhahu laysa biwajhi kadhab." Never. He said, when I look at him, I know this face is not a face of a liar. This is Muhammad. I pray that we see him in Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let's go to Jannah, inshallah. Why are we going to Jannah? And why this invitation? Allah is the one inviting us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Yunus, "Wallahu yad'u ila dar as-salam." Allah is calling us to the house of salam, of peace, to the residence of peace. Allah is calling. But before this ayah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if you go up ayah before this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a parable. He gave us an example of this life that we are living. He said, "Innama mathal al-hayati al-dunya kama'in anzalnahu min as-samaa فاختلط به نبات الأرض مما يأكل الناس والأنعام حتى إذا أخذت الأرض زخرفها وزينت وظن أهلها أنهم قادرون عليها أتاها أمرنا ليلا أو نهارا فجعلناها حصيدة كأن لم تغن بالأمس كذلك نفصل الآيات لقوم يتفكرون." To those who reflect, Allah said, the light and the parable of this life that we are living is like the rain that we send from the sky all the way to the soil, to the sand, to the earth, which absorbs the rain, and later it produces crops, fruits, which the farmer thinks that now is time for him to enjoy. With a blink of an eye, Allah said, we wiped everything as if it had not flourished before. As if it had not flourished. Allah said, this is the light of this life. A day will come, brothers and sisters in Islam, that I will be no more. I am dead. A day will come that you will become khabaru kana. He was. He was. A day will come on that day. That's it. So I will die and you will die. We will all die. A day is coming. We are waiting for that day. And after that, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are going to stay in the grave. Thumma amatahu fa aqbara. We have to live in that hole, in that narrow hole, in that darkness. Hello. No. After that, there will be a resurrection. وَنُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ فَجَمَعْنَاهُ جَمْعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we will order for the horn to be blown. And Allah said in Surah Al-Kahfi, فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا. Allah said, I will not leave anyone behind. On the day of resurrection, Allah will resurrect everyone, because He said in Surah Al-Zalzala, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. All the burden, whatever is under the earth is in it, Allah said, it will bring it out. So after that, my dear brothers, now there's going to be a judgment. On this judgment day, there are two sects on that day, only two sects. And this sect, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, a sect that is going to heaven and a sect that is going to hellfire. And these two sects, as you know, and you know that they are not the same. They can never be the same. أَفَمَنْ كَانَ مُؤْمِنًا كَمَنْ كَانَ فَاسِقًا. The one who is a believer, is he the same with the fasiq, the one who is disobedient to Allah? لَا يَسْتَوُونَ. They are not equal. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ. The one who sees and the one who is blind, are they the same? أَمْ هَلْ تَسْتَوِي الظُّلُمَاتُ وَالنُّورُ. Can light and darkness be the same? No. لَا يَسْتَوِي أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ وَأَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. They are not equal. They are not the same. So these two, my dear brothers, these two sects, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. Listen to the one that Allah is calling you and I for. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَى دَارِ السَّلَامِ. Ya Allah, you think He wants to punish us? Wallahi, no. Our Creator is Ghafoor. He is Ar-Rahim, Arham Ar-Rahimin. He is calling you and I to abide. He is calling you and I to the house, to the residence of peace, Al-Jannah. He is calling us. And as you know, Alhamdulillah, brothers, we are in the month of Jannah. We are in the season of Jannah, which inshallah, if Allah accept our deeds, we will be in Jannah. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaba, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaba, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. So we are in the mawsim, we are in the season of heaven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, there is something special kept for the believers. Allah said, first in the hadith narrated by Abu Huraira, is hadith al-Qudsi, he said, the Prophet said, Allah, the Supreme said, أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِ الصَّالِحِينَ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ. I have kept for my pious slaves something which the eye has never seen. وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ, and the ear has never heard of. وَلَا خَطَرَ, brother, and also the heart of a human being has never think about it. And this is proving the saying of Allah in the Quran in Surah Sajda, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. The soul, Allah said, this soul, you have no idea what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept for you due to your, inshallah, your deeds. جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. So inshallah, with the mercy of Allah and your deeds, you will be in Jannah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us some reasons of how and why inshallah, if you follow, you will be among the dwellers of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you a man of Jannah. May Allah make you a sister of Jannah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the first reason, amongst the reasons of entering Jannah, first, a complete and a sincere faith and good deeds. Complete and a sincere faith and good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Give glad tidings, give good news to those who believe in Allah and they do good deeds. They do the right thing. Brother, good deeds. لَا تَحْتِرَنَّ مِنَ الْمَعْرُوفِ شَيْئًا. Do not underestimate any good thing, no matter how small it is. Believe me, never underestimate it. Due to it, maybe inshallah you will be in Jannah. So Allah said to give good news to those who sincerely believe in Allah and they're doing the right thing. They know what Allah said to do. They know what Allah said not to do. They know what the Prophet is commanding them and advising them to do. Allah said,
إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات يهديهم ربهم بإيمانهم تجري من تحتهم الأنهار في جنات النعيم.
Brother, believe and good deeds with the mercy of Allah inshallah will lead you into the house of peace. We are in Ramadan. Last week I reminded you about zakat. Today I'm reminding you about the things that inshallah will lead us to Jannah. So let's go to Jannah. May Allah give us Jannah. My dear brothers, good deeds in Ramadan. You are in Ramadan. Today Fajr I was advising the brothers and sisters in Islam. We were crying for Ramadan to come. It's so pity. If you look at it, it hurts. Ramadan is going. It's gone. 10 days is up. And I was telling the brothers today, Fajr prayer, that you see these 10 days that is gone, you will never meet it again till the day of judgment. So whatever you did during the 10 days that passed, that's it. You have 19 or 20 days coming. What are you going to do in it? Because wherever it goes, it will never come back. So good deeds and iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, among the things, the reason that we put you in Jannah, as we said, complete faith and good deeds. Listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Kahfi.
إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كانت لهم جنات الفردوس نزلا.
Those who believe in Allah and they doing the good things and the right things that they're supposed to do, their place of entertainment will be Firdaus, Jannah,
خالدين فيها.
They abide in forever.
خالدين فيها
forever. No more pain. Only happiness. No more suffering. Only enjoyment.
لا يبغون عنها ولا
wanting nothing as a change. They want to abide in it forever, and they are going to stay in it forever. And what is leading them to that? Believing in Allah and good deeds. We are in Ramadan. So brother, لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Do not underestimate any good thing that you are doing. Can I give you another advice of something that will lead us to Jannah? Brother, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya ayyuhal nas, Ya ayyuhal nas, afshu salam. Oh, people, afshu salam. Spread salam. Spread peace. Spread as-salam. When I say as-salamu alaykum to you, it means I love you for the sake of Allah. It means I will never hurt you. It means I will never backbite you. It means I will never steal from you. It means I will never harm you. This is the meaning of assalamu alaikum. Now compare it to the assalamu alaikum we say to each other. Is it the same? Today our assalamu alaikum is tradition. Most of the time we are not saying it sincerely, because the word assalamu alaikum means a lot. This is the greetings of the people of Jannah. It will be said to us, to them, to the people of Jannah, before they enter Jannah, Udkhuluha bi salam. So the Prophet said, we should spread peace. This is the teaching of Muhammad. We should spread peace. Wa at'imu at'ama and feed. Give people food to eat. Brother, if you are breaking fast, you see the food that we are wasting, and you remember some people who will not have even a cold water to break their fast. You know they are living, they are close to you. You know some of them, are you feeding them? Look at the meat that you throw in the garbage. You don't need it, and you have no choice. If you keep it, no one is going to eat it. So at the end, it will end up in the garbage. Those who don't even have cold water to break their fast, you know them. Are you trying your best to help? Are you feeding? The Prophet said, spread the peace and feed people. And pray at night while people are sleeping. تَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةِ بِسَلَامٍ. You will enter paradise with peace. So you see one of the reasons, brothers, so let's try and make sure we spread the peace, and also we feed the poor, we feed the needy. Brother, it is very, very important for you to give someone food to put in his mouth. Wallahi, we have some rich and wealthy people. When they give you something and they give you food, you take it. He said, thank you. He is the one giving you, and he is the one thanking you. Because by taking it, you are helping him. You are the beneficiary. The one who is giving, you are going to benefit the most. Because it will be replaced to you. By who? Allah. من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها ويزيد. So brothers, do not underestimate any good deeds. Please try to feed the poor. You know them. You know what I'm talking about. Please help. Send them money. Give them something. Let them eat. Let them break the fast with happiness. They break the fast with something that when they see or they remember that inshallah tonight I'm breaking fast with so-so and so, you will see him happy. This happiness that he is feeling, Allah will make you more happier here and hereafter. So let's spread the peace. Let's feed the poor. Let's pray at night. And the Prophet said, we will enter Jannah with salam. And brothers, our time is up. But let me give you advice that I want everybody to start from now. You do. Do you know the saying of Ayatul Kursi? Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum will lead you to paradise. After every prayer, after every single prayer, 5 daily prayers, if you say it, the only thing that will stop you from entering Jannah is death. But you see, when we finish praying, because our enemy knows the importance of it, after assalamu alaikum, we just take the phone. That's what we do nowadays. Imam says assalamu alaikum, now everybody grab the phone. He's checking WhatsApp. He's checking Facebook. He's checking messages. Because Shaitan is trying to what? To take you out. He don't want you to say. You know why? Because he said, listen to what he said. Wallahi, he is our greatest enemy. Listen to what he said. قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. He said, I will make sure I take some with me. So please, let's watch that. After assalamu alaikum, I see some of the brothers over there. Assalamu alaikum, then phone. Do the adhkar. Only Ayatul Kursi. After every single 5 daily prayer, it will take you to Jannah. And my brothers, our prayers also, our time is up, inshallah. Keep up the prayers, inshallah. It will lead you to Jannah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Wa afina fi man afayt. Wa tawallana fi man tawallayt. And my dear brothers, I have advice. The first, second, third day of Ramadan, you will see not only this masjid, most of the masajid are full. But now, only few come to the day, night prayer. And some people are not coming until the last 10 days. You will see the masjid start getting full. No, some people will not do that. On the 27th night, the masjid no place to sit down. Brother, who are you deceiving? Your own self. And this is happening. So please take the advantage of the month. Maybe this is your last Ramadan. Maybe this is my last Ramadan. Only Allah knows. May Allah accept all our good deeds. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Wa afina fi man afayt. Wa tawallana fi man tawallayt. Wa barik lana fi ma atayt. Wa qina sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم